Hey everyone, welcome back to Okay Books. I'm Ellie and today I'm doing the first part of my February wrap up. I read 16 books in the month of February, so the same as I did in January. And yeah, it was a bit of a mixed month. There are some books I really liked, and unfortunately there are a lot of average books, so let's just get started. In the first part of February, or the first half of books, I read a lot of books that weren't mine, so there's going to be a lot of images and stuff, but yes. That being said, we are starting off with a physical book. That is Reader, I Married Him, stories inspired by Jane Eyre, which is edited by Tracy Chevalier. I rated this one 3 stars. This is a short story collection, and it's got a bunch of different contributors in there, which is why it turned out to be 3 stars. There were some in there I really liked and some that I didn't, so it just kind of like averaged out. And yeah, a lot of these, the connection to Jane Eyre was pretty, that's what I'm looking, it was a stretch. So I wish these had been a little bit more Jane Eyre-ish, but what can you do? Another physical one, I then read, and I left my bookmark in there, Ink and Bone by Rachel Kane. I was really excited for this one. And it was kind of a letdown. It was very different to what I was expecting, and it was just quite boring and slow paced, and I didn't really care about the main character. Like, I would have been more interested in reading about like 98% of the other characters more than the main one. So yeah, that was kind of unfortunate, but it's not a bad book, it just, yeah, not for me. We have this thing at my work where we do, every Monday we do this thing called Story Time, which is basically a free event where we read like picture books to kids. I got to do it once in Feb and I got to read 4 books, so I totally counted those towards my Goodreads goal because I read them, so it counts. So the first one I have was called Little Red Riding Hood. This is by Lucy Rowland. This was super cute, gave it 4 stars. Really liked the artwork and the story, and yeah. The next one was called The Little Bookshop and the Origami Army by Michael Foreman. I didn't like this one. Gave it 2 stars. I just thought that the story was like overly complicated for a picture book, and yeah, I didn't find it enjoyable. Next one is called The Stone Lion by Margaret Wilde. This was 3 stars. Again, it was okay, but I don't know, I like fun, colourful picture books, or picture books with really good messages, and this one was just kind of meh. So yes. Final one I have is The Very Cranky Bear by Nick Bland. I've heard about this one so many times, but I never really like looked into it. Yeah, I thought this was super cute, really enjoyable, and yeah, I gave that one 4 stars. And then I have a poetry collection. So I have Sunshine by Melissa Lee Houghton. This was another 3-star read for me. It was okay, but nothing special, and some of the poems made me really uncomfortable. Some of them are quite like sexual, but in like a weird way, and Yeah, that just made me a little uncomfortable. So yeah, it was okay, but I don't think I would ever read it again. I don't know. Sorry. Sorry if you can hear flies. There are like flies stuck in my window and I cannot get them out. So I'm waiting for them to, like, I've set traps and I'm waiting for them to die. So yes. Anyway, last one I have for this part is a DNF. I DNF'd, I think it was two books. Yeah, I DNF'd two books in February, and this is the first one. It's called The Life to Come by Michelle de Kretzer, I think is how you say it. So I gave it 2 stars because it wasn't a bad book. It was a short story collection, and I'm not really a short story fan. So yes, DNF that one, and yeah, that's really all I have to say about it. Okay, so that was the first part of my wrap up. I will have part two up on Friday, and yeah, I will see you all then. Thanks for watching. Bye.